What is going on, guys? It's Wav here. Welcome back to some more Jurassic World. Last time we left off, we actually made ourselves a digital miner, and that thing is probably getting us millions upon millions of Ooh, it's mining primarily amber ore right now. Ooh, that's actually not that bad. It's getting a lot of bones and stone and cobblestone. The thing about the fossils is that, you know, it doesn't have a guaranteed drop of fossils, so I guess that makes sense that we're getting a lot of amber. Someone actually left a comment saying that we used the wrong type of amber, like we used the biomes of plenty amber. So I went in and fixed this in the digital miner, so we're getting a ton of fossils and stuff now. We actually have 19 guaranteed dinosaurs there, and we're actually going to need to upgrade our chest over here. And God, I don't know, I guess if there's any better, like, storage inside here. I know there's not, like, diamond chests and all that, like, we have an end of earth and all that. It may have, like an ME terminals, ME stuff. Yeah, we can make, like, an ME, like, machine and all that, but I guess maybe we can do that here in the future. It's going to be a little bit complicated. We're going to need to go find those meteors and mine to the middle of them, you know, get all those little schematics we'll need for that stuff. But for right now, I think just making another regular chest is going to get the job done for this thing. So let's get this here, and let's make ourselves some more chests, and let's put our, actually, you know what, I guess, because this chest is, like, not being used, because apparently this hopper does not know how to use chests, so, I think we should have an individual chest, one of them for, like, you know, dinosaur DNA, and one of them for actual dinosaur eggs. Okay, so I guess the one with dinosaur eggs, that one can be a little bit smaller since we're going to be hatching those here, I wouldn't say pretty soon, but, you know, here in a bit. But for right now, before we actually hatch all those extra dinosaurs that we have, I want to, like, expand this area out. Our little herbivore area is getting pretty small, especially with how gigantic Littlefoot is getting. Look at how huge he is. He's literally, like, half of the whole entire place here. He's huge! Where's our other dino? Oh my god, look at the Hypsilophodon thing and Leg of the Stego. God, they're getting pretty big. What about our Herrerasaurus over here? Let's check up on our Herrerasaurus. Oh man, she's actually getting pretty big. Look at that. Yeah, she's getting pretty big there, Beefy, right? God, she's getting pretty scary, pretty spooky, pretty predatory. You better stay away from her. For the carnivores, what I want to do is, like, set up, like, individual pens, kind of like this, but maybe one or two more blocks smaller. Just, like, you know, individual pens, one dinosaur per pen, and then, you know, we can feed them, like, steaks and stuff like that here. I mean, we can feed them pork chops here in the future and, you know, give them, you know, sustenance like that, so they don't, you know, die. And because we can't, like, keep a bunch of carnivores in one area or else they'll, you know, eat each other, so we can't do that. We're getting this chest right here, because apparently this chest will not break or will not be suctioning up some dino DNA like we originally planned. Oh, let's not break that with our axe or else that's probably going to break the rest of our floor. There we go. Because we've got a pretty intricate little pattern on our floor and I don't want it to break, so there we go. And I don't know, I guess we could put our, you know, let's put our fossils up inside of there. I really don't know why it's not working with the hopper there. I don't know why it's not working. Anyways, we can put the amber inside here. I guess that's going to work whenever all the fossils are done. It's using the amber instead, so we not got another guaranteed Herrerasaurus right there. God, that's good stuff. 100% guaranteed, no problem. We need to make, like, a dedicated, like, chest. There's, like, no room here for, like, a dedicated chest for dinosaur DNA, so I guess we want to make, like, a two chest, like, right here, and see what happens. So let's put that like so, and I guess we could put this acacia like so. There we go. All right, so we could put, what could we put inside of there? I guess regular DNA that's not done. I guess we could put that inside of there, and then the eggs we can keep inside of there, because we're not going to have as many eggs as we'll have, you know, shred of DNA. So there we go. And, I don't know, should we have, like, a different chest for, like, 100% DNA, and then another one for, like, you know, fragment DNA that's, like, you know, 25%, and then, like, a 75%, 50%, like that? I don't know. How's this organize it? Oh, this one organizes it by make, so we have three Brachiosauruses, one Coelacanth, two Herrerasaurus, two Hypsilophodons, and, one what is that thing? Oh, that's like a little anteater-looking thing, I think. Ooh, and then we have a mammoth, Orthocantus, two Orthocantuses, three Parasaurophiluses, or Parasaurophili, I guess, and a Titanus, and a Triceratops, and then a Velociraptor, and two Tylosauruses. That's none too shabby, and of course our guaranteed Tyrannosaurus Rex and Velociraptor over here, so we're going to be adding those to our collection. I guess we can keep the dino pad inside there, because that thing's going to break our inventory in the future. I guess we could put another, oh, we can actually, Is this? No, it doesn't feed inside there. God. Ugh. All right. Well, I guess I'll be putting this inside here. So we got another coelacanth. We got a Tylosaurus. Is there anything else here? A mammoth. Lepidopterygon. And so what's our mammoth at? Our mammoth's at 50%. Oh, this one's 100. Yeah, that's 100 because it came from the amber. Ooh. What else is down here? Any more amber? Any more? Oh my God. 20 more amber. 16 more dinosaur fossils. Gee. Man, we're getting a ton of amber and stuff. More DNA guaranteed. No problem right there. God. We want a completely full chest right there. I guess we could fill this one up as well. Yeah. All right, well, another Hypsilophodon, another Hypsilophodon. So there we go. Actually, you know what? What I want to do is move this windmill thing a little bit farther, maybe all the way over there to, like, the shoreline over here, you know, a little bit farther away, just so it's not making that wind noise that it's making right now. And we should be able to afford that no problem, because we have a pretty decent amount of lead, and I think all we need is, like, glass. And I was cooking a little bit of glass. Yeah, we have a little bit of glass inside there. So we can make, a pretty decent amount. Let's get a few of those. And, let's see, let's just break those down into ingots, and I think what you need is, like, this, and then maybe, like, redstone on the sides or something. Let's actually look it up. No, I was actually kind of close. We do need redstone, and, yeah, we have a pretty good amount, but we don't need that much lead. We just need to put that like so, and redstone like so. That's 6. You know what? I get 4 crafts of it. I think 4 should be more than enough. Do we have, like, a regular shovel? A shovel that's going to break only one block it. Yeah, we do. Nice. All right. So let's, I guess we could dig this down like one extra block. Go down like this. There's that cobblestone. I had to pillar myself up with some cobblestone. Let's take this thing out all the way over to that shoreline over there. And hopefully we'll have enough. Actually, you know what? Let's trail our actual wiring behind us so we know exactly how much wiring that we have that can actually cover us. So let's go as far as we can go here. All right. Okay. This is about as far as it's going to get. And I'm not even upset. This was actually, it's actually a pretty good distance. Not bad at all. Alright, well, I'm going to have to break these windmill things. God, I still need to make a wrench. Let's see, what kind of wrenches do we have in this mod pack? Crescent hammer and the battle wrench. And, yeah, okay, let's just make the crescent hammer one. Yeah, we need 1 tin, 3 iron for that. Classic wrench. Let's go make that real quick. Hopefully we have enough tin. And we... this silver. That's aluminum. God, do we not have tin? I thought we... oh, yep, we have 10. All right, don't have to worry about that. And let's make ourselves a crescent hammer. There we go, and there we go. All right, so let's get rid of these windmills and the leadstone things here. There we go. And let's go move that over to the other side. God, get that wire, get that one piece of wire. That's all I need. There we go. Let's move our windmills over here, and it should make our area a little bit less noisy. We're not going to be hearing the sounds of wind 24/7. We're still gonna have to put both windmills like right next to each other, unfortunately. But let's see, how do we have to place them? Like this? Yeah, we do. Okay. And then we have to do that. All right. So there's that. I guess we have to place the dirt back and then we'll be good to go. Our power source is still just as good, if not better now. Actually, in a way, it's probably going to be the same. It's still the same elevation, so I doubt it's going to be any better than what it was, but it's a lot farther now, and we shouldn't be hearing a super loud wind noise. I'm still hearing the super loud wind noise. I don't know if that's actually what's making the noise or if it's actual wind. I don't know. Anyways, either way, that's actually out of the way, so we can, you know, expand here and, you know, put stuff here in our front lawn without our windmills being in the way. Either way, how much cobblestone do we have? Let's get ourselves all of our cobblestone. And, oh yeah, we're getting a pretty good amount of cobblestone from these things as well, from the fossils, if we're not, you know, getting guaranteed DNA. Orthocanthus, Hypsilophodon, yeah, pretty much the same dinosaurs over and over. Nothing new yet. I don't know if there's anything here that we don't have. We have 3 Orthocanthuses, or coelacanth. We have multiple of pretty much every dinosaur here, except for the Velociraptor, which we already have one of the eggs there. Well, anyways, let's see how many cobblestone fences we can make out of all the cobblestone that we have. Hopefully a pretty good amount. We can't make another craft. Yeah, we can. We can make one last craft. There we go. 2.5 stacks. That's a pretty good number. I guess we can go out and survey here. Actually, it was getting pretty dark out here. Let's zoom out a little bit here. You know what? Yeah, I'm feeling like maybe we can even expand this across the river over there, maybe, you know? Let's go see what that looks like over there across the river. All right. God, hopefully no spooky, creepy crawlies are going to try and kill me. I'm hearing a spooky noise. Okay, what's across that river? Seems like, yeah, just like dead land, and here's like a actual little lake bed or something here. This is the end of that little river thing. Not bad at all. And because they'd be herbivores, I guess we could put our sea creatures here too as well, and, you know, maybe even expand the lake a little bit and put our sea creatures there, but this is not bad at all. Yeah, we can extend it all the way out to here, so let's put that like about like that, and then let's start building a rough outline of where our fences are going to go. Now, I don't know how big our like herbivore area should be. I know it should be decently big. I don't want to make it too small because we do want our dinosaurs, you know, roam free, no problem. So let's see. So here's this wall. I'm gonna get rid of this tall grass that's here in the way, and ooh, that actually goes into that little river that starts over here. Nice. Let's see, how far out should this go? Let's go across the river, and let's look at a minimap. I'm getting, poisoned by the witch, no! Oh, I gotta go around, do not poison me, witch! Oh, I'm getting out of here, let's not do this at night. I'm going to bed. Oh man, I almost died last night, gee! God, okay, let's not plan out our area at night anymore, or else we'll literally get attacked by witches and almost die, gee. Anyways, I was looking at the map. And let's zoom out a little bit more. Yeah, maybe we should go down to the little lake bed down there. That would be a pretty large area, though. Anyways, let's keep on building our great wall. The great wall of dinosaurs. And we can always extend this, like, vertically in the future. But for right now, this is going to get the job done quite nicely. And actually, you know what? I'm going to extend it vertically on my own. Just so it gets done a little bit quicker. So let's see. How far does this go? And I did mention I wanted to go it all the way down to those little lake things down there? Maybe. Yeah, let's see how far away that is. We need to get rid of all this tall grass. Yeah? If we go across this little river here, that's good, yeah. Okay, let's get our iron axe, get rid of this tree that's in the way. There we go. Wow, I actually broke the whole thing. I didn't think it'd break that. I thought it was like two bushes right there. Alright, then we gotta go out here, break some more tall grass. Gotta go across the river, and, yeah, this is actually a pretty big area, especially whenever we go up north a little bit, yeah. Yeah, this is pretty good. I kind of like it here. If we want to extend in the future, we always can, no problem. But, you know, once we get to the top of this hill right here, I think this is going to be perfect. Absolutely awesome. It's going to be way, way bigger than we'll actually ever need for our dinosaurs, which is, you know, always good. Especially when we get a pretty good population up here in the future. Get out of the way there, you little cow. We want to leave you alone. I'm not gonna utter shot you hardcore there, cow. I've got other duties to do right now. Yeah, you're on the outside there. Alright, let's get rid of this tree. Get rid of this thing. There we go. Ooh, what's that thing? Oh, it's just like a random pillar that's like over there. There's another slime island. I still want to investigate those floating islands up there. I don't know how we're going to get up there. Other than like, you know, pillaring up cobblestone. Just nasty giant pillar of cobblestone all the way up there and investigating what that thing is. But for right now, let's see. How big outwards should it be out here? I guess it should go to the tip of the bottom of that nasty looking island over there. Kind of close to that meteor. I guess we could make it go all the way out there, although it would make it quite big. Alright, well, let's cut down these trees, and let's extend our farm, or not our farm, but our little herbivore area out there and see how big it gets. Wow, never mind, I completely ran out of cobblestone here, gee. Wow, anyways, that's actually not that bad of a perimeter. Yeah, especially because, you know, the north part of our island up there, I want to reserve that for our carnivore little pens, you know? So, yeah, this isn't that bad. I think I'm going to finish this here on my own. But for right now, we need to go name some dinosaurs. I had you guys leave some comments down below for quite a while, you know, asking what we should name our Herrerasaurus, what we should name our Hypsilophodobodon. And I did ask about our T-Rex, but we are not going to be laying that guy just yet. Not until we have our carnivore pens up. So you guys are going to have to wait for that one. But gee, Littlefoot is gigantic now. And where's our name? Do we have any extra name tags, or we have to make more? Yeah, I think we might have to make more. We might have to go get some more of that sugarcane here and make some more paper to get some more name tags. There we go. I had to fight off that witch just to go to bed, so I had to break a few of my sugarcane here. Let's try and replant our sugarcane. Here are our little miniature farm. I wouldn't even call it a farm. It's just a little area to just grow sugarcane next to our infinite water pool. All right, so what do we need again? Gelatinous slime and I guess, oh wait, that's a lead. Where's our, oh man, we have like, we were getting really low on gelatinous slime. We need to go. I guess we can go investigate that slime island up there while we investigate that one random floating island up there as well, you know? So it's like gelatinous slime there, paper there, two paper, I guess. Then we can put some string like so. There we go, two name tags. Perfect, that's all we need for our hip level for the... Oh, I don't even have enough levels to even name them. Oh man, I need to go kill some stuff. Ooh, I'm seeing an Enderman. Ooh, let's go down to the cave system down below. Try and get a little bit of XP from there. Ooh. And I guess we could mine some ores, you know. Mining ores gets you a little bit of XP. Here's some coal right here. Let's see. Is this going to take us up to level 5? Nope, not quite. Oh, there's so much coal here. So much. I guess... I don't know. I was thinking maybe I could throw it into the heat generator. Get a little bit of extra energy out of it, you know. But at the same time, we have... pretty much unlimited energy with our windmills over there that are completely maxing out our what is it, like, hardened energy cell thing over there. Gee, that's taking up a ton of energy. God, I don't think we're going to get up to level 10 here anytime soon. We're already level 5. I guess we can go name one dinosaur for now, and hopefully later in the episode, maybe we'll get enough XP to where... Oh, is this even... Did it mine everything? Don't... Oh... Either, I think it did. It says to mine zero. Oh, let's look at the config. Oh, reset config. Wait a second. Let's look at this thing. Radius 32. Well, let's put that to 9. No, yeah, that's maxed out though. But man, that's dank. We have so many dinosaur like fossils and stuff like that. God, we have like no room here, dude. Let's get a little bit of these guys out and transfer them over into this chest. Completely full of dinosaur DNA. Gee, Titanus again, Lepidopterin, Dilophosaurus. Ooh, I think that's our first Dilophosaurus, right? Yeah, it definitely looks like it's... Yeah, it's, there's no other Dilophosaurus eye over there. So, ooh, another Triceratops, another Stegosaurus. I'll definitely take those guaranteed dinosaurs. Carnotaurus. Ooh, another Herrerasaurus. We're getting a lot of dinosaurs. Look at that. Man, weird. I did not imagine us getting so many dinosaurs, like, already. Like, I expected us, oh, and we're still going to be mining for, you know, fossils, like, 20 episodes into the series. But nope. Looks like we've literally mined every single fossil, every single piece of amber in our, like, 32 block radius. So, if we want to get more ores and stuff, I suppose we can take our more fossils and stuff. We can take our digital miner and the capacitor bank, move it, like, I don't know, like, 50 blocks over there and see what happens, you know? Another Tyrannosaurus Rex DNA. Don't mind if I do another mammoth. Oh my god, we're getting tons of stuff. This thing's almost full. We're gonna have to put it in this second chest over here. Aw, man, we're already filling this one up. Gee, god, we still have 11 more amber. 11, whoa, we're getting a lot of this Carnotaurus here. Ooh, another Dilophosaurus. Okay, anyways, god, name tag. Jeez, I keep getting sidetracked. Anyways, I guess first, what did we have first? Did we have the Herrerasaurus first or the Hypsilophodon? I think we had the Hypsilophodon first, right? No, I think we had the Herrerasaurus first. Let's put the name tag there. Oh, there you go. And I got a comment saying to name the female Herrerasaurus Hera. So apparently Hera is like the wife of Zeus or something, which is actually kind of cool. You know, it kind of ties in with the name, you know, Herrerasaurus and Hera. So, you know, and it's a female. I got a lot of name or male names in the comments down below. So anyways, here's Hera the Herrerasaurus sitting down. Oh my god, look at that. Sitting down, not sitting anymore. I don't think... Do the other dinosaurs have that animation whenever they sit? I don't know. They might have. Maybe they've just been too small and I didn't notice it at the time. Yeah, I have a Steve skin for some reason. I don't know why. Anyways, let's see. Nope. Littlefoot is sitting. Littlefoot is not sitting. Yeah, no animation there. Lego the Stego. Nope. Doesn't look like anything different there. All right. What about you, Hypsilophodon? Oh, the Hypsilophodon has an animation too. Oh my god. Looks so cute. Oh man, that looks fantastic. Oh, jeez. Anyways, wow. How do we like not have any cobblestone? Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to go head over to the village over there, to my old house, pick up all the cobblestone we have over there, and get a bunch of those cobblestone walls started. And actually, you know what? Let's get started on our carnivore pens, because might as well... like, make our carnivore pens, get rid of this here, move our Herrerasaurus, Hera the Herrerasaurus, and make, I don't know, a half dozen carnivore pens over there? I don't know how we can, how many we could fit over there, but maybe a half dozen or so, you know? Maybe eight, maybe? Anyways, I'm going to go over to the village, and I will see you guys here in a bit.